I, like many other people on this earth, enjoy music. I like good music. I like bad music. I like music that has no words. It's a proven fact that people who are deaf look at sheet music and go, now that's some good shit. That's why I admire Araki's dedication of making references to so many artists within his work. You know, you got Killer Queen, Green Day, AC/DC, Star Platinum. I also admire Araki's way of writing these musical references into his characters. Araki may not do this with all of his stands, like I'm pretty sure White Album is called White Album because it's fucking white, but a few of them are incredibly inspired and written in a way that reflects what they're a reference to. I want to go over some of these because there are some incredibly interesting ones. The one I do want to talk about the most, however, is Man in the Mirror. Alright, so at first glance, you probably think this stand is called this because it's a man in the mirror. What a fucking genius move, Araki. But hold on, I'm telling you there is so much more to this stand than just the simplicity in its reference. I won't go over the entire fight against Man in the Mirror because a lot of it is irrelevant to what I'm trying to point out, but just know that this stand has the ability to access the mirror world as well as drag other people into it. By the end of the fight, Jordan infects himself with the virus from Purple Haze and allows himself to get dragged into the mirror world, infecting Illuso, the user of Man in the Mirror. This prompts Illuso to cut off his own arm and leave the mirror dimension, where he is greeted with Purple Haze and killed. What I find so interesting about this is that when Illuso leaves the mirror world, he gloats and is proud of his own resolve to cut off his own arm and leave the mirror dimension. He's proud of the change that he made in himself. Now, to draw parallels between this fight and the song Man in the Mirror by Michael Jackson, I have to bring up the lyrics and the meaning of the song. So, looking at the lyrics, the song is obviously about changing yourself for the better. I'm starting with the man in the mirror, I'm asking him to change his ways. However, if you look further into the lyrics, Michael Jackson is singing about changing yourself not just for selfish reasons, but for other people as well. If you want to make the world a better place, take a look at yourself and then make a change. He also sings about helping those that are less fortunate than him, and expresses that he's been a victim of a selfish kind of love, which inspires him to make this change. Now, knowing and understanding these lyrics gives me such a big appreciation for how Araki has written Illuso as a character. He directly goes against the lyrics and meaning of the song he's a reference to. Think about it, he leaves the mirror dimension and cuts off his own arm for selfish reasons in that he wanted to survive. This change wasn't for the benefit of others, it was completely selfish, and therefore he dies because of it. Also within the song, Michael Jackson states that change begins when you look into the mirror, but Illuso's change literally starts when he decides to leave the mirror. I absolutely love how Araki has written his character to be the complete opposite of the song he's a reference to. It's genius. Good job, Araki, this is good writing. Now this is bad writing. Moving on to the next stand I want to discuss is Killer Queen. She's a killer queen, gunpowder jealousy, dynamite with a laser beam, guaranteed to blow your mind. Now, the parallels between this one are incredibly obvious. The song Killer Queen constantly references destructive behaviour, guaranteed to blow your mind being one as an example. Therefore, we can draw conclusions that the main idea behind Killer Queen's ability is inspired by such destructive behaviour expressed in the song. However, if you look close into the lyrics of the verses, we see a lot that reflects Kira as a character. The line, to avoid complications, she never kept the same address, could refer to Kira changing his character halfway through to avoid being caught. Alongside this is also the line, insatiable and appetite, which when applied to Kira could refer to his need to sever women's hands. Furthermore, from what I do know, the song is about an escort and the verses serve to describe her classy and professional behaviour, but in contrast the chorus reveals her true personality. This is similar to Kira in that to the average person he's seen as normal, but deep down he has this lust for murdering women for their hands. Also, I want to point out that Killer Queen being a cat may be a reference to how Freddie Mercury was a big fan of cats. He took care of 10 in his life. Also, I like this stand because there's a cat within a cat. This says a lot about society. Anyways, on to Bites for Dust. So the first verse in combination of the chorus of Another One Bites for Dust refers to death. I believe that the repetition of the line Another One Bites for Dust refers to how multiple people are dying. However, what's interesting about this song is that the second verse shifts the topic to being about complications within a relationship. Freddie Mercury later goes on to say that there are many ways to hurt a man, you can beat him, you can cheat him, which I think refers to how hurting someone can have many definitions and that you can hurt them physically or emotionally. I believe that the lyrics in the song are reflected in Kira and Hayato as characters. The absolute violence in the first verse could refer to Kira's destructive and murderous behaviour, whereas the second verse could be interpreted as Hayato being deprived of what his life once was. Not that it was much anyway. Honestly, I'm not that confident in this interpretation, so you can choose to agree with me or not. I feel like I'm forgetting one. Oh yeah, sheer heart attack. Sheer heart attack is called sheer heart attack because if you take the first letter of every song within the album, you get Book to Flunisnudismzai, which is the sound Kira made when Jotaro beat the shit out of him. The next stands I'm going to go over are more minor in comparison. They're not as in-depth as the previous two, but they're still pretty interesting. Starting it off, we have Heaven's Door. This is Rohan's stand with the ability to open up people's faces and change things about them. There's way too much going on with this stand, and I'm not going to bother to explain it all. What I find so interesting about this reference is that the song Knocking on Heaven's Door by Bob Dylan repeats the same line 20 times, that line being knock knock knocking on heaven's door, which could be interpreted as someone who is beginning to face death. I believe that Rohan and Heaven's Door within the Bites for Dust arc is a reference to the repetition used within this song. Not only does Rohan have to face death due to Killer Queen's third bomb, but he has to face it several times, just like how the song constantly repeats the same line referring to death. Another stand that has small detail attached to it is the Bohemian Rhapsody stand from Part 6. On the surface level, this stand has the ability to bring fictional characters into reality. The song Bohemian Rhapsody by Queen starts off by asking, is this the real life or is this just fantasy? I believe that these two lines are linked to the stand itself in that within the arc, because fiction is starting to emerge within reality, the lines between what can be considered real and fictional are blurred. This leads the characters to question what is real and what is not real, just like in the song. Anyways, that's it for the video. I hope you found this at least a little bit interesting. There's definitely a lot more than what I covered, but these are just a few that I noticed when reading the series. With that being said, maybe the next time you're introduced to a stand, whether it be from part 8, or perhaps when part 6 is animated, try listening to the song it's a reference to. You might discover something interesting. Like how Triss's entire character development is literally a direct reference to Wannabe by fucking Spice. You wanna be my lover, you gotta get with my friend. Make it last forever. Friendship never ends. If you wanna be my lover, you have got to get